What's up, everyone? Welcome back to the Coral Reef Talk. Today, I want to talk about the aquarium in a jar. Now, I know it's been a while since I've done an update on the 210-gallon reef aquarium, let alone an update on the aquarium in a jar. So if you're new to the whole project of me starting this little reef aquarium in a 2-gallon mason jar, go ahead and check out the playlist and get caught up. I'll also link in the description below the videos for you to follow along. Okay, so I'll have to admit that this reef tank in a jar has definitely been a new experience for me, and I started off on the right track. Everything was going really well, and then things got busy. And mix a little bit of busy with a little bit of neglect, and things can go bad really, really fast. So what happened? Well, when I was first setting up the reef aquarium in a jar, I didn't pay any attention to this small piece of algae that was growing on one of the rocks. What type of algae was it? It just so happened to be Caulerpa. Now, when Caulerpa grows, it can grow like a vine, and it goes in and out of the rock work, and it just covers everything in the tank. Now, to be honest, I kind of wanted it to grow, so I removed the hammer coral and the frog spawn coral from the reef in a jar, put it back in the 210-gallon system where it's safe and it's doing just fine. But why would I want this stuff to grow when I've been having months of success with it in the tiny aquarium? Well, one part of me wanted to see how fast the Caulerpa would grow and potentially ruin things in the aquarium. Now, I know I'm gonna catch a lot of heat for this in the comments, and I hope it doesn't get too hot. Allow me to make these mistakes so that you don't have to when you're setting up your own Pico tiny reef aquarium in a jar. Now, I know, I shouldn't have let things get so out of control and out of hand, but what I found fascinating about this is that the aquarium in a jar became a safe place for amphipods, copepods, and brittle stars. And it's not the amazing colors of the beautiful corals that I know everyone was hoping for, but it was very interesting to see these creatures up close. Now, the aquarium in the jar will get back up to speed, but there's some work to do. So now what I have to do is get the Caulerpa out of this tank by removing it manually. So I'm gonna have to take the rocks out, pull off the Caulerpa, and then do a water change, put the rocks back in, and I'm also gonna add a few rocks with corals into this tank. So right now I have some zoanthids in the 210-gallon tank that aren't doing so well in that system, but all the soft corals that are in here, even with the Caulerpa, are still doing really well and they like this little tank. So I'm gonna add some more zoanthids to the tank and hope that they grow out really nice. Here you can see me cleaning up the aquarium in a jar. First I had to remove the Caulerpa, but that's easier said than done as the Caulerpa was growing in and through the rock work, so I had to remove the rocks as well. Now, peeling the Caulerpa algae off of the rock wasn't really that easy, so I decided to get rid of those rocks and use completely different rocks in the new aquascape or setup of this little aquarium. Now, in addition to removing the rock work, I also had to worry about the quality of the water, as I didn't want to miss any of the Caulerpa and risk it growing back again later once I set up the tank. So I had to perform a few water changes and get things back up to speed. So what are my plans for the new aquarium in a jar? Well, it did work out really nicely with LPS and soft corals, that I think I'm gonna start with soft corals. Mostly zoanthids, as I'm gonna build a beautiful zoanthid garden in this tiny aquarium. And then from there, I may throw in some other soft corals and move slowly into adding LPS. So we're starting from scratch again and we're gonna see how it goes, and I'm gonna keep you guys updated weekly as I plan on sharing the aquarium in a jar on Wednesday so you can see the progression. That way things don't get lost in the mix and you're wondering what's going on. Now, life does happen sometimes, so if you don't see an upload on Wednesday, don't worry, I will try to get that video out to you by the end of the week, and it may be short clips of the tank, maybe some video of me telling you what's going on with the tank, but regardless, I will give you guys an update so that you know exactly what's going on with the aquarium in the jar. So that's it for the update on the aquarium in a jar, but don't click away just yet because I have something very cool that I think all of you guys will enjoy. So premiering tonight on Netflix, directed by Jeff Orlowski, is a film called Chasing Coral. And Chasing Coral is about how climate change is affecting the ocean and causing coral reefs to bleach out. Now, this was filmed over the course of 3 years, and it's filmed very cinematically, and it's done really well from what I can see in the trailer. You have time-lapse photography of coral reefs that are healthy, and then you see them change over time and eventually bleach out. I think Chasing Corals is going to be a great film, and for anyone in the reef aquarium hobby or anyone who cares about the coral reef and the environment should check this film out. Now, if you like movies like I do, be sure to check out some of my other video projects that I currently work on, as I'm a co-host on the channel Visual Recreation with my friend Andrew, and we do funny short little skits over there, as well as a weekly video where we talk about new movies and how they will play out in the box office, as well as Fantasy Movie League. Now, Fantasy Movie League is a fantasy game where you select movies each week to make money for your Cineplex. Now, it's a free game to sign up for, and it's a lot of fun to play. So if you're interested in some of my other projects, I'll leave a link in the description below, but check out youtube.com/visualrecreation. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you have questions about anything at all, please leave it in the comment sections below. Remember to like and subscribe to this thing if you're not already, and I'll see you next time on the Coral Reef Talk. Thank you.